Hello students, today we are going to discuss a new topic from module 5, that is buffer solutions. First, what are buffers? Buffers are defined as a compound or a mixture of compounds that by their presence in solution resist change in pH upon the addition of small quantities of acid or alkali. जर्नली जो ये बफर्स होते हैं दे आर मिक्सचर ऑफ कंपाउंड्स दैट मीन्स मोर देन वन कंपोनेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट इन योर बफर दे बेसिकली रिजिस्ट एनी चेंज इन पीएच व्हेन यू ऐड एसिड और अल्कली ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट बफर्स हैव अ लिमिटेड कैपेसिटी दे कैन रिजिस्ट दिस चेंज इन पीएच अप टू सम लेवल दैट मीन्स स्मॉल एडिशन ऑफ your acid and alkali can be taken care of while we are dealing with buffers. The second important definition is buffer capacity. The amount of acid or base required to produce a unit change in pH in a solution is called the buffer capacity. I have already said buffers have a limited capacity. So the range in which that buffer resists any change in pH is called the buffer capacity. What are the characteristics of buffer? Buffer should have a definite pH value. You should be aware of that pH value. Next, pH value of the buffer does not alter either on keeping for long period or on dilution. That means, agar aap zyada der ke liye us buffer ko rakhte hain, store karte hain, aur aap usko dilute karte hain, aapke buffer ki pH mein koi change nahi aani chahiye. Next, the pH value of the buffer is very slightly altered by the addition of small quantity of acid or base. Always remember this particular thing. Buffers do not have unlimited capacity to alter or resist any change in pH. They can resist this change only when a small amount of acid or base is added to it. Applications for buffers are similar to the applications which we have already discussed for pH. Buffer solutions, if used, can enhance the solubility of the drug. If you know ki aapki drug kis pH pe zyada soluble hai, aap us pH ka buffer use karenge and its solubility can increase. It can increase the stability similar to your solubility. If you know at what pH your drug is stable, you can prepare a solution of that drug at that pH using a buffer of that pH, and this will increase the stability of your drug. It will improve the purity. Here you can take the example of protein. Proteins get precipitated at a particular pH, jisko hum kehte hain isoelectric point. Apni isoelectric point pe proteins precipitate out ho jati hai. If you know the isoelectric point of your protein, you can easily precipitate out your protein and you can improve its purity. Next, absorption of drug. A drug which is present in the unionized form will be better absorbed. If you increase the unionized fraction of your drug, you will definitely improve the absorption of your drug. Ab drug kitni ionized rahegi, kitni unionized rahegi, that will be dependent upon the pH. If you remember the Henderson-Heisenberg equation, aapki pH determine karti hai kitni drug ionized, kitni unionized form mein present hai. So if you increase or if you alter the pH of your lumen to such that greater amount of drug is present in the unionized form, you will definitely improve with the absorption of your drug. Next, you can optimize the biological activities. Your enzymes have maximum activity at a particular pH. On both sides of that pH, they will have compromised activity. So if you know pH of your enzyme where it has the maximum activity, you can improve its performance. Converting to the body. If you want to administer your drug via topical, via ophthalmic or via intravenous route, you have to ensure that the pH of your system must be compatible with the body surface. Next, storage of products. On storage, sometimes what happens that the container and the closure which you have used to store your product leak out some components in your stored product, and it can alter the pH of your content. Altered pH will influence the stability and solubility of your drug. So if you want to ensure that on storage your drug must be stable, you can use some buffers, as the components which get released into your content during storage will not be able to change the pH of your content. Next topic is buffer systems. Now we have these five types of buffer systems which can be used as a buffer. The first category of your buffer systems are combination of a weak acid and its conjugate base. Here you basically use the salt of weak acid with a strong base. Agar main example do, acetic acid along with sodium acetate comes under this category. Ye aapka buffer solution ban sakta hai. Second category of buffer solutions is weak base and its conjugate acid. Here the example is the salt of weak base with a strong acid. जिसमें example आ जाती है ammonium hydroxide की with ammonium chloride. The third example is combination of two salts. Sometimes if you use monobasic potassium phosphate and dibasic potassium phosphate, you can prepare a buffer solution of a particular pH. Fourth, amphoteric electrolytes, for example glycine, can act as a buffer solution. And the fifth category is a strong acid with a pH less than 3 or a strong base with a pH greater than 11 can be used as a buffer solution. Isme example aa jati hai hydrochloric acid buffer ki. In this hydrochloric acid buffer you include potassium chloride along with. Next aa jate hain ki buffer action kaise hota hai. If we divide this category into three, let's discuss the first category, buffer action of an acid buffer. Abhi humne example ki an acid buffer ki. In an acid buffer we have a combination of acetic acid and sodium acetate. So if I take the same example, this is my sodium acetate. Sodium acetate is a strong electrolyte. So it will get completely ionized in water to give you sodium ion. Along with that, acetate ion. So this will completely ionize. Along with sodium acetate, we have acetic acid with us. Acetic acid is a weak acid. So it will partially get ionized. That's why we are using this symbol. When it comes in contact with water, it will form H3O positive and acetate ion. So this will completely get ionized, this will partially get ionized. So when you take a mixture of sodium acetate and acetic acid, you will have excess of sodium ion, you will have excess of acetate ions, but you will have a limited amount of H positive or hydronium ions. So if we add a small amount of acid into it, is mixture mein ab hum small amount of acid add kar rahe hain, to kya hoga, the H positive or the hydronium ions of the acid, these are from acid jo humne add kiya hai, they will combine with the excess of CH3COO negative acetate ions to give you back acetic acid and water. So that means जब आप स्मॉल क्वांटिटी ऑफ एसिड ऐड कर रहे हो, उसके जो एच पॉजिटिव आयन्स हैं जिसने पीएच को ऑल्टर करना था, दे विल बी टेकन अप बाय योर एसीटेट आयन्स. वो जल्दी से आपके एसीटेट आयन्स उठा लेंगे और एसिटिक एसिड एंड वाटर में कन्वर्ट हो जाएंगे. ठीक है, दैट मीन्स वो हाइड्रोनियम आयन आर नॉट प्रेजेंट टू ऑल्टर द पीएच ऑफ योर सोल्यूशन. So on the other hand, if we add a base to your buffer solution, अब मैं इस buffer solution में कोई base add कर रही हूँ. Base का क्या component होगा जो alter कर सकता है मेरी pH को? OH negative ion. जैसे ही base अपना OH negative ion donate, जैसे ही मेरा base अपना OH नेगेटिव आयन में डिसोसिएट होगा, दैट ओ एच नेगेटिव आयन विल बी टेकन अप बाय द एसिटिक एसिड एंड इट विल गेट कन्वर्टेड टू एसिटेट आयन एंड वाटर. दैट मीन्स दिस ओ एच नेगेटिव आयन ऑफ द एडेड बेस इज नॉट अवेलेबल टू चेंज द पीएच ऑफ माय सॉल्यूशन. इन दिस वे माय बफर एक्स और वो पीएच को सेट करता है when we add small amount of acid or a base. If you look over here, you can see that here your CH3COO negative ions are basically entrapping your H positive or hydronium ion, and acetic acid is basically entrapping your OH negative ion. As their amount is limited in your buffer, आपने बफर में इनकी अमाउंट लिमिटेड अमाउंट में डाला है इसको बफर में. दैट मीन्स वंस दीज टू स्पीशीज आर यूटिलाइज्ड कंप्लीटली बाय योर एच पॉजिटिव और ओ एच नेगेटिव आयन्स, आपका बफर का एक्शन स्टॉप हो जाएगा. सो दिस इटसेल्फ एक्सप्लेन दैट योर बफर एक्शन इज नॉट अनलिमिटेड, इट हैज सम कैपेसिटी. सो मूविंग अहेड, if we take the second example of buffer action of alkaline buffers, here we will take the example of ammonium hydroxide and ammonium chloride. Here your ammonium chloride is a strong electrolyte, so when it comes in contact with water it will get completely ionized. On the other hand, your ammonium hydroxide, it is a weak base, so when it will come in contact with water it will get partially dissociated and will give NH positive and OH negative ion. This will be completely ionized, but this will have slight ionization. So what will happen if we add acid to this system? Acid will provide hydronium ion. ये आपका एसिड प्रोवाइड करेगा. इट विल बी इंट्रैप्ड बाय योर अमोनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड मॉलिक्यूल, वो उसको इंट्रैप कर लेगा इमीडिएटली एंड इट विल गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू NH4 पॉजिटिव एंड टू वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स. ऑन द अदर हैंड सिमिलरली, इफ अ बेस इज एडेड, स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ बेस इज एडेड, base will give OH negative, it will be taken up by your ammonium ion to give you back NH4OH. So the hydronium ions of the added acid or the hydroxyl ions of the added base will not be available to alter the pH of your buffer. In this way your alkaline buffers work. The third category are your amphotericic substances or amphotericic electrolytes, जिसमें हम example ले लेते हैं glycine की. Glycine behaves like an acid. वो acid की तरह कैसे behave कर सकता है? This is your glycine. When it comes in contact with water, it will give you this ion and hydronium ion. It can act as a base. How? This ion will combine with hydronium ion to give you a Zwitter ion. Zwitter ion is one which has both positive and a negative end. This will play a very important role in the buffering.